Data points often come structured. In little groups, so picture might look like. Like this. And the task of clustering is to discover these groups and characterize them. So that's referred. So we have clusters, that's the name of these little groups. And clustering is the process of finding these groups or these clusters. Now, one distinguishes between hard clustering and soft clustering. In hard clustering, one partitions the space such that any point is uniquely assigned to one cluster. So here one might split, for instance, the space along this line, or along this line, and state that any point in this area belongs to one cluster, any point in this area belongs to another cluster, and likewise this one. To visualize soft clustering, it's useful to draw the points in two different colors. So let's assume we have a process where we have two clusters. One would be here, and another one would be here. Then even though there's sort of one cluster, so there's a concentration of points here and a concentration of points here, there might be a region where the points sort of overlap, where there might be points from one cluster or the other cluster. Now in hard partitional clustering, one would simply draw a line here and say all the points on the left belong to the green cluster and all the points to the right belong to this pink cluster here. In soft partitional clustering, sort of one characterizes the clusters and say, okay, we have a cluster here and we have another cluster here somewhere. Well, that's not a nice ellipse. Here. But, so you can think of these as Gaussians, and that's actually how they're often modeled. But then also in this region, the points are not clearly assigned to one cluster, but one says, okay, in this region maybe the points are assigned 50% to one cluster and 50% to the other cluster. So the points get a probability belonging to one of the clusters or to any of the clusters, and it's not an all or none decision. I've called this already partitional clustering, and that means you partition the space into regions belong to a cluster that doesn't have to be sort of one-to-one or zero or none decision, can be sort of 50%, 50%. But in contrast to this is hierarchical clustering, where you consider different scales in which you can do the clustering. So if you have following situation, so we have points here, we have points here, we have points here, here, and here. So then, depending on the scale on which you consider these data, you might either say, well, you have 5 clusters, this would be 1, this is another, 3, 4, 5. Or you say, well, there are 2 clusters, 1 is here, and the other one is here. Or you say, there's just 1 cluster. So depending, and if you go to the fine extreme, you can say each data point is a cluster, right? So depending on the scale at which you look at it, you can have different clustering results. And if you sort of represent all these different clustering results, that would be referred to as hierarchical clustering. And there are 2 versions of that. So the one is the agglomerative hierarchical clustering, where you start with individual data points being clusters, and then you group them more and more, so that in this case would be sort of going from the blue clusters to the red clusters to the orange and through the yellow. And the alternative is a divisive procedure, where you first consider all the data points to be one cluster, and then you split it here in order to get the orange clustering, and then you split it further in order to get the red clustering.